Aaron, as you guys probably know by now. So as I mentioned yesterday, for some of you guys who weren't here, I spent a lot of time in Japan. I lived there like 13 years. I went from white belt to black belt all the way in Japan. And I have a big influence from my instructor and a lot of other guys who I trained with who come from judo backgrounds, some conventional judo backgrounds, some Kosen judo. If you don't know what Kosen judo is, simply it's another form of judo that kind of separated from the normal Kodokan judo a long time ago, maybe near 100 years or so, I guess more than that now. And it's still practiced at the seven imperial universities in Japan and some other places as well. But their rule set is different, and their focus is more mat work oriented, neiwaza. A lot of the common techniques that you know, the ground triangles, like all these things, all came from this, right? And some other things, and you know, a lot of people took credit for things because they kind of went to Brazil and came back around and other things, but the Japanese were doing a lot of this stuff a long time ago. If you see some old footage and stuff like that, you'll see a lot of spider grab, daily hilo, like all this stuff is kind of been around. So some of the guys, a couple guys that I used to train with, my instructor and then a couple of other guys maybe kind of made this specific stuff that I'm going to show today more famous. It's kind of these weird shoulder locks, right? And that's what I'm going to show you today. I know it's kind of confusing if you don't know what it is. Probably some people thought we were going to do takedowns and stuff like that, but it's mat work, okay? So basically what I'll do, I'll start off kind of showing you the basic lock, and then we're going to progress into some variations of that, as well as some sweep options when things might not work out for plan A. So if I could have somebody to help me, I'd appreciate it. Anybody want to volunteer? This isn't going to be this one's not going to be super bad like the choke one yesterday, where that poor man is probably in the hospital. Kidding. Okay, so there's a number of different ways to do this. So simply kind of what we're looking for from this is we're looking to set up an arm isolation thing, right? Many different ways to get there. I'm gonna show you like one or two, but there's many ways to kind of get this thing. So what I'm really looking to do, I'm just showing you this and I'm gonna show you some pictures. And I'm looking to get the arm isolated on the ground somehow. I'm looking to get an arm isolated so I can overhook it and feed to come normally. I'm looking to get it overhooked over the arm and feed the lapel as tight as I can get it. Okay? This can come through a number of ways. I'll show you a couple now, and I want you to, I'm not sure how many of you guys that kind of play this style of jiu-jitsu where you're trying to isolate an arm to the ground. I do it a lot because I like triangles in my game. It's sort of like that, so I'm looking to do this. A couple common ways are, I'm sure you guys have maybe seen like grip breaks where they do this sort of thing. Maybe you've seen that. Maybe, I kind of like this way a lot where I'll break the hands, use my legs to knock the posture down. That's one way. This is not necessarily a class to show you all the entries to this, but I'm just gonna show you a couple so you can maybe practice that. Other ways that this happens, he's maybe on a single leg or something like that, where you just, yeah, and I can feed it here. And I'm looking to get this, okay? So however you wanna set it up, let's just practice a couple entries and getting it, and a couple key points. I want you to be as high up on, I don't want you to be low on the elbow right here. I want you as high up on the closest to the shoulder you can get, and I want four fingers palm facing out, and I want it, take this other hand and get it tight. The looser it is, it's gonna be harder. There's more room for things to go bad. And I want you here. And that's where we're gonna start. So just practice a couple setups quickly. I'll just show you one if you wanna do this way. Maybe your hands on the thing. When you do this, guys, you kinda, no matter how you set it, your hips kinda wanna come out a little bit. Because that's the way we're gonna be doing it. You're not really gonna finish what we're doing straight ahead. So practice when you come up, just sort of getting here. Does that make sense? We're gonna just kind of do it in baby steps, and then we'll kind of accelerate a bit. Any questions about that so far? I know it's kind of simplish, but everybody got that? Does anybody know the most badass, the most successful 17-time world champion of pro wrestling. Who's the baddest man on the planet? Anybody know? Yeah. Anybody know who he is? It's Ric Flair. The Nature Boy. Right? Airplane flying, limousine riding, Rolex wearing. Right? So we don't clap, as I mentioned in my other classes. I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, and you give me the best woo that you got, all right? You guys know the Ric Flair woo?
Yeah.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Woo!
All right, everybody, come back in. That's pretty simple. I think you guys can understand that pretty good, but I just wanted to make sure that you're getting it nice and snug up there. First technique I'm gonna show you, it's kind of got popularized under the name Comlock from a guy named Koji Komuro, a judo guy that I know in Japan, and another guy who's friends with him named Okamoto, Okalock. And they won a ton, I mean a ton of tournament matches with this first one and variations that I'm going to show you later. So we're here. Let's say we got this, all right? I want to tie it like this. Now, this is the motion that I'm looking to do here. I like my feet on the hips. Some people kind of like having just one foot in and kind of like a butterfly. Me personally, because I'm kind of, I got longer legs, so I kind of like to have my foot on the hips. And a couple of key points, like when you're setting up this first one here, you don't want this leg to be like super lazy, because if it's just kind of weak, he can push it down and maybe like starting to, yeah. You don't want him to start coming over. So I'm here, and I'm kind of creating like a bit of a sandwich kind of with this, right? And then to finish the choke, or not a choke, the arm lock, it's here. Okay, so I know it's kind of hard to tell like what's going on. A couple things I want you to see. I didn't do it on the first one, but sit up a second. So when you're finishing the arm lock, I want you to twist. This twist, my hand when I'm doing it, this twisting motion puts the arm kind of right where it needs and takes kind of the slack out of the arm. You kind of feel how it's torquing. Right now it's kind of loose, but when I turn it, it's just the turn in and of itself is putting pressure on the joint. And then I add in all the other stuff where I'm isolating it. Okay? I know it's kind of one of those things you can't like kind of see what's happening exactly, but it's arm, it's kind of a few things. It can be the shoulder, it can be the arm. And I just like to grab this, everything's tight, and I'm twisting and finishing that way. Does everybody understand?
Yep.
Anyone need to see it again? Wanna see it one more time? Yeah, sure. Blame your buddy back. Blame your friend back there. He's the one torturing you. Gee. So I'm here. We're here. We've got nice tight legs, everything. We're kind of creating like a little bit of a man sandwich here. We're here. Sorry, I'm getting in the mouth. Twist. Push. Twist. Twist. And push. This is kind of isolating it so it doesn't move around a lot, like have it here on the shoulder. I'm twisting this like quite good, and I'm kind of extending it off. All good? Yeah, thanks.
So, question.
Yeah.
So what's the direction of the press here?
I'm just kind of holding it, kind of extending it.
Okay.
That's not so paramount. I'm just kind of keeping it so he's not moving around so much, right?
Okay.
If I don't have it, you know, he might be flailing a little bit more. It just creates a little bit more structure to apply the technique. Make sense? All right, guys, more feeling this time, okay? With the woo, please. I'm a little tired today. I need the energy, and the woo's gonna bring it, okay? 1, 2, 3.
Woo!
Hold on. Hold on, guys, 1 second. I see kind of already what's happening here. People don't like it, and they turn the hand upwards, which takes the pressure off the elbow. We're gonna address that, right? Like I saw you doing it, like your arm, you're naturally, you kind of want the thumb and hand, the back of the hand to stay up. When the hand turns over, it's not really on the joint anymore. So you get it set and keep the legs and everything locked, it's harder for them to do that, but inevitably people start kind of doing that to take the pressure off it. We're gonna address that in a minute. So just make sure that you're just, the person who's being arm locked doesn't just do like this to take it off. Make sure the person gets it set, because there are variations where we're gonna counter that, but if you're not getting it, I guarantee you that's probably what's happening right now, but we're gonna address that, okay? As some of you have seen, the hand does sometimes go like that, right? Especially the pressure comes, and that's sort of the natural thing. Kind of like a, like an omoplata, people start kind of, they want to relieve the pressure, so that comes down. But you can feel that a lot of the time. Once you practice it more, you can tell when that joint kind of, because it starts going to the, you kind of feel it kind of go to the outside, the elbow. I know it's a little bit hard to explain. But the more you do it, the more you'll understand. So, a couple of options. We're starting to get into option time, right? It's not just about arm locks and things. So I'm here. Maybe I'm trying, the arm gets turned out or something like this, right? Now we can finish it from the top. Also, arm lock option, another arm lock, which I'll show kind of with a roll later, but we can finish from the top. Now we're kind of getting into some other variations, and this is kind of the way I do it, because the more things you can attack them with, the same time, the easier it is to finish, even from the back. I don't always hold the shoulder, which you can finish that way, but this is my go-to. Right here, I think we know what's gonna happen. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of trying to be a little bit nice, but I'm putting this right in the neck right there, kind of next to the windpipe where your arteries and all that yummy stuff is right there that you wanna stop making his brain work. But see, we can do this, and we can do both. So if we twist the arm, we can get an arm lock and the choke. And do you care which one taps the person? Not really, right? You got the top. So let's go back to the, this is always an option, even here. I'll do this most of the time, even from this one. But sometimes people are tough, things happen, whatever. So let's say we're not doing this, he's not tapping. We're here, the hand goes up, and I feel like maybe I can't get it. I don't know what it is. You grab the hand. A lot of times when you do this, they kind of fall on it like this a lot of times. If not, I'll kick it. Anybody ever been in one of my scissor sweep classes where I kind of do this technique to pull myself up? Now I'm here. It's kind of like rodeo boy position, right? You can finish that just like that. Or if you want to, yeah, I'm not going to torture. You guys understanding? So now we've added two extra layers here. We've added a thrust choke, and we've added a kick out sweep option. Any questions about either one of those? If you need to see that again? We tracking here? We making sense? Yeah, I mean, obviously the gi kind of helps retention and retaining the arm, but yeah, there are like a lot of overhook things. You can do it like this, right? I can't grab my gi and no gi, but you can. There are things, but it's going to be easier for them to just, yeah, slip out. You got to be kind of, have a really good bite on it. But yes. And then all these things will still work in no-gi too, right? And then if I'm here in no-gi, right now, I mean, all this is still in play. Just less friction. There are some other pitfalls, but yes, you can still, it's viable. As well as the, I'll show you, I'm gonna show you another little variation that also works well too, coming next. Anything so far? We got it? So we got a thrust choke that we can add into the mix. If that hand's not working, you wanna give it a little bit more sauce that way. And then if you wanna sweep, not only are we still in a choking position from there, then we've added points, right? We've swept, we're in mount, essentially. And we're in a good finishing position, and we've just added some points to our total. Make sense?
Yep.
Like where we're going? All right, the last one was good. Don't disappoint me on this one. One, two, three. Woo-hoo! Quick. I'm not sure, Wim might know for sure, but like in the jiu-jitsu rules, I don't think in the gi you're allowed to do the thrust choke without holding the gi, so, right? So you wanna make sure you get a little bit of a grip on the lapel to finish. I'm not sure if you can just do it with your hand. I know at one point I think it was illegal, but right, you gotta grab it. You gotta have the gi, but in no gi, it doesn't matter. So just make sure, like, same thing. The ref doesn't see it, I guess it's not illegal, right? So just make sure, same thing with grabbing inside that, you know, people do it all the time, but you pretend like you roll it up. Just make sure you kind of make it look like you're getting part of the thing, because I don't want you to get disqualified and go, that son of a bitch, Aaron Ross, he told me this crap. And so just make sure you get a little fabric in there when you do it, all right? Couple of things that I want to make sure that you are aware of. I mentioned it, but I want to make sure that you are mindful of it always, or else people that are better will be wise to your tricks. So these feet, obviously, yes, when you kick it out, right? That's one thing, but you don't want this dangling here, because sometimes people can spring up and they're this way, and then you gotta reset, right? So I always want this sort of thing. If you kick it out, it's different, right? But don't, in a general sense, don't leave them dangling there. And I saw a couple of people that were, they haven't had their feet like, no, it's, both feet are on the hips, sort of pointing in the same direction. My feet are kind of like this, and we're here. Okay. A second thing, when roll over real quick. So once I take them down, another variation of this, real quick, is this is always a variation that we can do as well, right? Just to give you kind of a another thing that you can do that I didn't do it in this thing because I don't always do it, but you could butterfly on this side, like once, especially if they're bigger and need a little bit of extra oomph, but you wanna make sure you come out of it, right? You don't wanna end up in half guard for no reason if you don't have to, okay? Additionally, I showed a couple of people here, this arm sometimes, it turns in, yeah, they turn it, the arm down. Well, but, turns into a kimura, basically, right? So there's a lot of extra little things there. Make sure your feet are up. Let's try that extra variation where you scoop the arm on this one here. And then when you're on top, if that arm gets twisted like that and you can feel it, try turning it like that and get that little kimura lock there too. Anybody need to see that again, or does everybody else? Okay, so I'm here. It's not working. I'm scooping. When I'm doing this, I'm not pushing straight back because the friction is very strong. He's got a lot of leg there. I'm kicking it out that way, kind of 45 degrees off his center line. You can use the butterfly. Sometimes I kind of inherently just push with that. We're here, we have all the same stuff. Sometimes it's a shoulder lock and that, but if it comes down, it happens sometimes. You can kind of just, I like to grab the leg so you guys just keep sliding here. Sorry. Just a little extra thing, it's there. Doesn't work all the time though, but it's there. All right, so let's try that other scoop. And then we got 2 pounds of shit to fit in a 1 pound bag the rest of the class. We're gonna try to squeeze it in there, though, okay? 2 kilograms of shit in a 1 kilogram for you Europeans. Just any questions until we go? 1, 2, 3.
There we go.
Okay, so I think you, we're seeing that some of the options here, right? If we can't get the finish from the normal way, we will start initiating some sweeps. But sometimes maybe you can't sweep them that way. I think I did this to Tom yesterday, a couple days ago. I'm gonna show you from the other way. So we're here. Yeah, nice good grip. I got grabbed like this, right? So I couldn't, it was kind of hard for me to, I couldn't do to this side. So, let me turn on. So anytime that this sort of thing is happening, we have the option to go to this side as well, the arm side. Just make sure people on the bottom, like if you do it, make sure your arms tucked in. Yeah, make sure your arms kind of tucked in a little bit because you can hurt somebody's wrist. So I'm here, I push this way, and I'll either get behind the arm or it could be behind the head. This one does help a little bit with the butterfly hook because you just need a little bit more oomph sometimes to go to that side. So let's go back. I'm here. If I'm too tight, it's harder, so I'll kind of move out a little bit to give myself more room to push on. And now I'm back here. Rewind the tape. We're here. Try not to stop. Maybe whatever. I think the arm is out. Yeah, for something it doesn't work. I can grab under the arm. I can grab around the head. Sometimes I'll just use my knee like this, like a John Wayne sweep. Anybody know what a John Wayne sweep is? Anything that kind of just creates some force that knocks them over. So when I have a scissor sweep class, and I scissor sweep to both sides too, with these leg kickouts. This is no different from here. Okay, one more. You can also do it, right now I'm kind of making sure he's a little further away, right? Because me, I got longer legs, so I can't get my foot on the hip. But you can also step on the, sometimes you can stretch them out like this, where the leg's extended now. Now I can do it with the leg extended, as well. So depending on how close they are to you, it's easier for sure if you kick that knee outward to sweep it, but you can also kind of extend the leg, push on it, and then initiate the sweep. Make sense? Any questions?
If your opponent is much heavier than you, then you still can push the leg.
To be fair, like if that happens, mm-hmm. Yeah, it can be a little harder but that's kind of when you can start working both sides, just like really good butterfly sweepers. Mm-hmm. They're going back and forth, like Adam Morzinski, like he'll get some this way and they come back and then it goes back the other way. So being able to work, and I'll do that same thing in the scissor sweep. So like if I'm here, I might do this and then they react or something a certain way. Then I might be able to come back. So maybe use motion to do it. But you can also, plan A, with that added choke, goes a long way. I mean, if you really just want that one, I'm not trying to dismiss any of these other ones, because if you want to sweep, maybe you need points or something like that. You're not getting it, but just adding that sauce in the neck. If you get all this locked in, it's kind of, I wouldn't say it's impossible to defend, but it's some work. And what they're going to probably try to do is probably roll to get out of that, and we're going to counter that here next. So let's just practice going to that other way real quick. I don't want to spend too much time on it because you kind of understand it. Any questions on that? You guys know what we're doing, right? We're sweeping to the hook side now. You can use a butterfly hook to do it, but when you sweep it, make sure you take it out, because why get stuck in half guard if you don't have to? So take it out and just come to mount. Or some people like to go the Casey and Tommy. All right, so that's an option too. But just take it out. Any questions? 1, 2, 3. Ooh. So, one very common thing that happens, which can be countered, is, especially when you're from here, people don't like all of, they look to roll a lot of the time to relieve the pressure. Kind of just like when you get somebody into like a pretty deep alma plata, like people are looking to roll out to relieve the pressure, and it's kind of no different here. They will really, really start.
Yeah.
When that happens, you want to make sure that you block the back. So just like you saw my class the other day, like having that foot on the back is going to take you with him. If not, he might be quick and he might get out. Like, yeah, I might still be able to recover, but we don't want that. Come back. Let's rewind that. We're here. All this is going. Maybe he just bigger, stronger, whatever. He gets the jump on me a little bit and he starts going. All right. Again, need arm first. Here, I'm trying it. That doesn't work. I feel that they're putting pressure. Yeah, I'm not able to hold them off for a minute with my feet on the hips. But let's say that I'm losing the party here. Here, we'll roll. You get that? Magic, right? Luckily, there's a camera and nobody else would have believed it. Okay. Anybody need to see that again? Anybody in the back? We're here. Super tight. It's not working. I feel that they're just rolling. It's going for it. Over the back. I'm going to catch the leg. This one's kind of a little bit, if you're not super flexible, that you can get this in front of the face. You might have to loosen it up just a hair. Give yourself a little room, but make sure all this is tight. This is tight, knees are together. Be careful, this one can be pretty strong on the arm. And 1, 2, 3. Woo-hoo! Again, time is of the essence, and we lost it. In this case, we're out of time. So I'll show you kind of a couple little variation things that kind of happens, just so you have ideas of other things that you can do. And then we'll get into the Street Fighter world. E. Honda is the best character, by the way, in Street Fighter, in case anybody needed to know that. So another option that we always have here in this sort of situation is, we got chokes. A lot of times, this might have happened to a few of you, where this elbow kind of gets peeked out. Yeah, where the elbow kind of comes out a little bit. That's a really quick arm lock. That happens like that, kind of that Frank Mir, Gann McGee arm lock. Where the elbow, you see the elbow gets turned? Get that sort of arm lock. Yeah, I mean, there's some other variations to get into all this. But I hope you guys learned something. I use this all the time. I made it a point the other day to do this to everybody that I could, just to, you know, warm myself up for the class. Any questions about any of that so far? Or, I mean, we're done. So any questions about anything before we cut loose here?
Just to get back to the beginning of the lesson. All this was part of Chosen Judo. already part of the
league. Yeah, this, I mean, it's, some of that stuff is not exactly 100% clear, but yeah, this is like kind of Kosen judo, pretty classical judo stuff, mat work. And I mean, yeah, it's a little bit blurry, you know, especially if you look in the history where the Maeda was like, did he train with these guys? Not when he vacuumed up, who knows exactly what happened 100 years ago in some dojo trading secrets, but yeah, all the guys I learned is from were Kosen judo guys, my instructor included. So, anything else? I will wrap this up and say, listen, it might not work the first time we practice it here in the thing. You might be like, it doesn't work. But believe me, this works. I can send you tons of competition footage of guys wrecking people with this all the time. Just like anything else, you have to put the work in order to succeed. There's no shortcuts, there's no magic bullets, snake oil, unstoppable this, undefendable. Like, guys, it's not real. There are things that are good, that are better than other things, but you have to put the work in. There's no shortcuts. So just keep remembering that. I hope you learned something. And if not, well, as I always say, it's your fault because this stuff works. Now, thank you very much for coming. We're gonna get into the Street Fighter competition. Thanks to Christian, all the organizers, and mostly thanks to you guys for coming, because if not, we wouldn't be doing shit. We'd be here by ourselves. So thanks again.